such a nostalgic time in my life. It brought back the subtle memories of childhood with possessions that I cherished the most. Children become so emotionally attached to these cuddly toys, blankets, and even smelly old scraps of fabric because of the intuitive belief that these items possess such a unique essence. It's important to note, because of such investments put in cherished objects, their intangible qualities can rarely be replicated or replaced. Do you remember your favorite toy growing up? Providing comfort and providing joy were just some of its very many qualities. It didn't matter whether it was a doll, a stuffed bear, or a plastic car. That was your favorite toy, and you loved it more than anything else in this world. I can bet that some of you could not sleep without this toy, had to eat with your toy, and maybe even went as far as serving a cup of tea to your toy. Our love for these cherished objects became so influential in our development. We anthropomorphize objects, looking at them almost as if they have feelings. Over the years, these treasured pieces prepare us for life. There were a few things I cherished the most as a little kid. My porcelain tea set, Ducky, my favorite puppet, and most importantly, my rosy pink fleece blanket. I learned to love and respect things that meant so much to me that I would go to the ends of the earth to have this blanket with me at all times. As time goes on, we grow to cherish new things, right? A note from your friend, a necklace from your grandmother, never without a special personal meaning or quality. But when does our love stop becoming so materialistic? When did we stop turning towards our stuffed animals and instead reached out to our best friends for an embrace? When did we begin to save our I love yous for people, moments, and God? I would like to read the gospel for you one last time this morning. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant, searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it." In both instances, the person knew instantly that they had found something that was incomparable in its value. Both emphasize the great sacrifice that one must be willing to make for an environment associated with the Lord's kingdom, where we may find peace and peace with ourselves. A personal relationship with God is possible through Christ. The value of this relationship to Jesus is tied to our happiness and ultimately fulfillment. Therefore, when we lose our sense of happiness, we come to realize that we have lost sight of this value. If nothing compares to Christ, nothing should keep us from him. The gospel this morning speaks of a treasure, hidden and found again, everything being sold for this treasure out of pure joy. What a beautiful treasure in this kingdom of God. Every day is a beautiful day in God's kingdom. Every day we are members of God's family, living in this kingdom. Thus, every day is a magnificent day if we have the eyes of faith to see and the heart to love. Living in this kingdom is a source of joy and blessings, optimism and hope, goodwill and common good. God is here for us, but we must actively seek him out. The quest for God is worth it. It is and will always be worth it. Today we recognize an infinite, matchless, incomparable value because it cost the Son of God his very life. As we live out the charisms of Dominican life, let us move forward in the glistening light of the most radiant treasure that is the kingdom of God.